Hi, good afternoon. We're going to talk a little bit about some of our logistics modeling and simulation that we do for military service and the Department of Defense. I'm Phil Churchill, the Senior Director for Logistics Solutions here at Concurrent Technologies. This really describes the presentation in total. It talks about the capabilities that we have in that we've done in logistics data integration, logistics modeling, simulation, acquisition and sustainment logistics, as well as supply chain automation. Some things of note that I'd like to point out is the master data repository that we operate for the Marine Corps, which gives true authoritative and authoritative data for Marine Corps systems. We operate the life cycle modeling integrator. We do other things that for the Marine Corps that brings the decision makers the capability to make logical decisions based on factual information and authoritative data. We've also done modeling and simulation for the Army in the opportunities for reset of equipment, also optimization to provide them a way to simulate the best courses of action in resetting their forces. We also do some acquisition and sustainment decision support tools, which captures information in a way that enables program managers, acquisition managers, to make sound decisions, to optimize the warranties that they've received from their contracts, and ensure that contractors are performing as the warranty indicates. Administration of warranties, packaging, sustaining the forces, all of these opportunities are things where modeling and simulation is applied and can be fruitful in making sound, logical decisions. The Lifecycle Modeling Integrator is a family of systems that we provide and services we provide for the Marine Corps. Single source of information, authoritative information for the program office, for the master schedulers, for the depot, the master scheduling support tool. Helps them operate two Marine Corps depots, maintenance depots. The START applications help them provide optimized level of repair parts to ensure that the repair parts are available and ready to answer the call that the warfighter needs those items to repair their equipment. AIMIT is automizing and optimizing particular weapons record books. It helps you see when you need to replace your gun barrel. When is it going to fail? What's the opportunity to provide preventive and corrective maintenance in an opportunistic way? Merit application is used throughout the Marine Corps. It basically talks about the readiness of the Marine Corps, what's needed to sustain the Marine Corps, where the problem areas, what equipment is going to fail and when. This is the new capstone concept for the Marine Corps, TLCM, Total Lifecycle Management, OST. It's a business intelligence decision support tool for the Marine Corps. Enables you to make rational decisions in supporting your equipment life cycle. It provides early warning on certain NSNs that are providing problems. It helps you optimize your equipment, understand what needs to be repaired, what pieces of equipment are not performing as they should. And it provides a common operating picture, not only for cost, but also for future decisions. One thing I want to point out is this is a bridging technology that also incorporates the legacy system. With the advent of GCSS Marine Corps, just as the advent of GCSS Army, GCSS Air Force, we capture not only the new information captured under the new systems, but we also capture that legacy information and blend it together so that you're not losing any historical data. You've got all the historical data, and all of the information that you're making decisions on is based on that integrated data source. AIMIT is an automated record book. It provides specific pieces of equipment, records on number of rounds fired, when the last bore scope was done, what parts were installed in that piece of equipment. One of the new opportunities that we're doing with this is this is mostly for crew-served weapons or weapon systems such as the howitzer and the mortars, those types of crew-served weapon systems that have many components. Many components are not tracked and are basically lost. So if you install a gun serial number such and such, you may lose the tracking on that. You may not know when that was installed. When was that engine pack installed? How many rounds have gone through, and what type of rounds have gone through? Also, this system can help you enable a forecast of when that system needs to be modification instructions installed, and what modifications have not been installed on your weapon systems, most of your crew served weapons. So it keeps track of engines, keeps track of barrels, keeps track of those components that are essential in the safe operating of that equipment. Tesla, life cycle management. Many times in a piece of equipment, when you're acquiring a piece of equipment, you need to make sound decisions based on the performance of that equipment about where your money is going to go, where your dollar is going to go in order to repair and replace that equipment to ensure that you're going to get the maximum life out of that piece of equipment. So what this application does basically is it helps you forecast and make decisions and objectively takes facts and figures, applies not only cost, but frequency of repair, mean time between failure, the time from repair to back in service. All those data points are captured, and you can see in this example, you can see that the largest concentration here for this piece of equipment is the body, those items related to the body of the vehicle. And so that's a source of further investigation and drill down. You can make those decisions if you're a program manager. How much dollars do I need to allow for class 9 parts? What parts are specific to the vehicle based on initial performance and initial operating of the vehicle or the weapon system? And I can see what needs to be repaired or replaced, and I can see what I need to do to optimize the life cycle of this weapon system. This was an application we developed for the Army. Cost modeling for reset. The Marine Corps uses this to optimize their reset costs. Is it cheaper to replace the item of equipment? Is it cheaper to put it into a partial repair type program, where you can take the piece of equipment and optimize its life cycle based on only repairing certain parts of the equipment? Or is it better to go ahead and dispose of the equipment and buy new equipment to replace it? This helps you do what ifs. It's your sandbox where you can take and put, if I buy 50 tanks or if I buy 25 tanks and repair 50, what am I optimizing my dollars? This is a way to improve your efficiency, improve your acquisition dollars, optimize those to enable you to qualify your justifications for budget reasons. You can put real facts in here, and you can identify those facts based on the optimization model. Again, a lot of the things we did for the Marine Corps is based on an optimizing data and authoritative data source. This is the master data repository we operate for the Marine Corps. It provides 23 supports over 23 application exports information to 10 applications. It also captures maintenance management, financial acquisition data from Sabres, and transportation in transit visibility data, all inside this one data source. So all of the applications throughout the Marine Corps, for example, can go to this one data source and pull out the information it needs. Many applications have improved their effectiveness. They already exist, but many have improved their effectiveness because they've gone to the master data repository and acquired the data instead of acquiring it from their legacy system. Because the master data repository, again, captures not only the legacy application, but it also captures the GCSS Marine Corps application as well. This is something we're providing counter ID training cells to support TTPs and training cadres in the Air Force and the Army. We're not currently doing this for the Marine Corps, but we support providing up-to-date modeling of what's going on out there in the battlefield, helping the trainer cadres so that they can go out and train the soldiers and the airmen. We support currently the training support centers. We provide operation and training support of training events and training development plans in these locations. We also support the current Infantry Immersion training program for the Marine Corps. Site management, operations management, range support and scenario designs. We put the experts there with the active duty folks to make their product better, to make the warfighter, to ensure that the warfighter is trained and ready to go to war. That concludes my presentation. I'll take your questions at this time.